How do you, as a producer, see yourself keeping up with the demand and at the same time being able to ensure that that keeps going on the farm, with preserving obviously the land and the ability to supply as much as is wanted and ensuring that it's going to continue to go on from there?
To start with some background, I'm a third generation farmer here in Ontario, and I've got an 11-year-old son, and of course we're in it for the long run, and part of that means setting our land up and maintaining it in a way that hopefully my son, if he so chooses, would be able to carry on the tradition in the family. And the way we do that is we stay pretty abreast with latest technology that's out there. There's different types of farming in the background. There's organic, there's traditional lifestyle farms, and then there's the corporate business-oriented operations. But we realize that to be in it for the long run, we want to take advantage of the technology that's out there. And part of that means using pesticides in a controlled way that are legislated. It means soil sampling. It means using a CCA, a certified crop agrologist, and having all of our fields scouted. We're using a lot of the latest technology as far as electronics go with GPS on applying our inputs, the pesticides, fertilizers, and that to prevent overlap. We're also using satellite imagery based with our soil testing, where we're checking for nutrient levels to variably apply some of the products that we put on our fertilizer. So we're feeding what we expect the crop to grow based on different soil conditions and climatic conditions. The other thing around science that concerns me a little bit is the perception that as a farmer, we're just out there willy-nilly throwing these chemistries and products on our crops. The reality is, I'm in business to stay in business. We work on a margin. And, we're using advice based on independent agrologists. We're using it based on what we're targeting, whether it's a weed or an insect or whatever the disease is. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to put a product on there and spend dollars an acre to do that just because that product's available. We're doing it because there's a specific need for that product. And we're putting it on at a rate to target that pest. We're using GPS technology, so I can steer that piece of equipment. It steers itself, literally, within a 2-inch line from one end of the field to the other. We're now running 120-foot booms out there in some of the larger operations. So you take a 6-inch or a 1-foot overlap across 120 feet, it's insignificant.
As you said, we have like a third generation farm that's moved along. Mm-hmm. And like you said, your son, if he so wishes, the kind of things that you foresee him looking at when it's coming up, like challenges and the opportunity?
I'm envious when I look at the young breed of farmers that are coming on now, how savvy they are, how technologically advanced they are, how open they are to accepting new ideas. I'd say the generation prior to me was a little more tradition-bound, but they didn't have these technologies or opportunities available to them. Part of the reality is, I think the average age in Ontario now is pushing 60 or in the late 50s. Every census has proven we're getting older and there's fewer of us. And so by default, they're going to have to become better managers. They're going to have to be more involved in HR, in marketing, and not just mechanics. So farms are going to get larger. That's not a bad thing.
Okay.
We've seen that happen in every industry. I think everyone can relate to that. Why shouldn't that happen in agriculture too? I'm envious of that generation. I look at my son and, the world's his oyster.